So hey guys, welcome to my channel, Dex here. Today I'm going to talk about the RDBMS. This is the Relational Database Management System. For a database management system, we can store different kind of data in a systematic way. So how do we define systematic? One way is to just put all the data into tables. So it's that simple, right? Here is an example. We model the database as we store information about the participation of activity by different students. As you know, table contains different kind of records and columns. For each of the records, we can also call it as the row, and then for each of the attributes, we can also call it as the columns. So we can also call a table as an entity. Usually behind the data, it must be something that relates to our daily objects, like places, people, events. So these are all the entities. It could be represented by a table in a database management system. So entity tables are the same thing. Records, rows are the same thing. Attributes and columns are the same thing. How about the domains? For domain, it is a set of allowable values for a field. Like in student's name, it should only contain alphabet, but not numbers, not other kinds of symbols. In my example, for the activity, it should only contain the photography club, the networking club, and dance club. If we put in something like music society, it shouldn't be here. If I put in dance society, it isn't here. So it's a concept of domain. How about there are multiple laux in this example? That is joining the photography club. The problem is that we couldn't even distinguish whether there are two laux both joining the photography club, or is it a duplicate records? We couldn't distinguish from this table. So let's look at another table in our example. It's called the students table. Each of the row is a record about a student. A student ID, student name, class, and class numbers are the attributes or the columns. There's another concept that I'm gonna introduce here. It's called a key. For a key, it is a set of fields that can uniquely identify a record. In this table, there are two choices for us to identify a record. One is obviously the class and class number put together, and then way is to use the student ID obviously. We choose one from these two choices, student ID or class plus class number. My choice is to pick the student ID as a primary key, and then for the non-primary key, it's called an alternate key. So let us go back to the problem of the laux. One of the obvious ways for us to solve the problem of multiple laux is to replace the column of student name in the activity participation table by the student ID. In this way, we can distinguish the two laux from the records. As the student ID column in the activity participation table is actually referring to the primary key of the students, we call the student ID column on the activity participation table as the foreign key. It is a reference to the primary key of the students table. Foreign key and the primary key actually establish the relationship between the students table and the activity participation table. Finally, there are three kinds of common integrities in the RDBMS that I gonna introduce to you. One is called entity integrity. That means each of the records in the database system must have a non-null unique key. For example, each of the activity participation, it should have both the student ID and the activity itself, because this information can uniquely identify and participation of a student. And then for the students table, each of the students should have a valid student ID. Referential integrity, that means all the references should be valid. In our example, it means that for each of the activity participation, student ID, it should be referring to something that actually exists in the students table. Finally, for the domain integrity, that means each of the fields on the record, it should contain only the value that are allowed and valid. Here are some of the keywords that we covered today. That's it for today. If you like this video, hit thumbs up, subscribe, and comment down below. Catch up with you guys very soon.